Hi, I'm Jennifer. So I went to China just recently to visit my family. So while we were there, we were out to dinner and we were ordering a whole bunch of dishes. I asked them specifically not to put MSG into the food, which is monosodium glutamate. And I speak fluent Chinese, mind you. So I was quite articulate and they understood exactly what I was asking for, or should I say not asking for. So they were unclear of the situation. They went back to the kitchen, asked around, came back to me, reassured me that there was no MSG in the food. All right, I'll drop 100 real on that. So I did. 2 hours later, there definitely was MSG. Got a few rashes. Pretty sure that's one of my reactions towards it. So even though I don't have a language barrier, imagine if someone that can't even speak Chinese and tries to say, hey, I don't want some MSG in my food. If I'm getting it, I'm pretty sure that you're gonna get it too. So there must be something that can definitively detect what is in the ingredients of our foods. And that's where I realized, if you wanna eat clean, you have to strip clean, plus strip. So similar to pH indicators in pools, it can test for what's in your food, the MSG content, whether there is MSG or no MSG at all. So it's a disposable and affordable product that allows you to test for MSG with just a swipe through your food. So I guess the first question would be, why is MSG so important? I understand that I'm personally have some side effects, but to the general public, MSG, in general, it is an excitotoxin. So basically, it excites your cells to the point of deterioration, similar to some drugs. It's a commonly used flavor enhancer, and studies suggest that anywhere from 25 to 40% of the U.S. population is intolerant. The study was done about 20 years ago, so they are now saying that this number has increased dramatically. According to the FDA, excessive intake has been linked to triggering or worsening of learning disabilities, Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, ALS disease, and many more, such as slowing down your metabolism. These are just a few of the detriments of MSG in the contents found in your food. So MSG, the proper scientific term would be monosodium glutamate, and it is an amino acid. So of course you can look at the labels to see if your food contains MSG. However, there are over 40 substitute labels that contains byproducts of this that causes the exact same reaction. So just to name a few examples would be free glutamate acid, autolyzed yeast, calcium casenate, gelatin, hydrolyzed protein, and sodium casenate. Due to statistical evidence and negative side effects of MSG, it's clear that in general we want to avoid it. But now it's easier than ever to overlook the contents of our food because of these substitutes. With this product strip, you will be able to easily test for what food products contain MSG as well as MSG byproducts. Because of the indicator strip is designed to be sensitive for reactions from the amino acid. So for the implementation plan, enough about the theoretical basis of this idea. Now let's focus on the detail-oriented implementation plan that transforms this idea to actual market product. So this is an example of a competitor, ANP Technologies, who made a similar testing product that tests for pesticides and toxic metals in water. I show this example to a random survey as well as a more commercialized product, and they much preferred the commercialized product, mainly because you don't want to pull out a test kit at the table and then let everyone think you're going to cause a hepatitis C epidemic. were about to sneeze syphilis all over their plate. That's just a little freaky. So for my market share, Strip's target market is the natural and organic personal care. According to the natural and organic personal care products, this particular market size grew 61% to $7.7 billion during the period of 2005 to 2010. It's projected to top over $11 billion as of 2016. This is likely due to an increase of personal awareness regarding healthy personal care and habits. The selling point of Strip is that it provides people with the capability to make healthy eating more attainable. It has the objective of becoming a major participant in the natural and organic personal care industry. And the most notable targeted customers would be those who are naturally allergic and those who are predisposed to all side effects. So for my SWOT analysis, the biggest strengths we have is the competitive advantage of patent rights. So this allows us 20 years leeway from our date of filed patents, which is a great barrier to entry for other competitors. The biggest opportunity we have is wide market penetration, which is allowing our product to be a multinational product. Our weakness would be timeline pressure on research and development, and our biggest threats are competitors who have infringements on patent rights, which is quite frequent. For financing this, the initial cost would be a $90,000 startup capital. Where this numbers come from is that, so part one would be design and manufacturing the product. So raw materials are $490. I contacted a small pharmaceutical company to ask for these numbers. And we divided it into three parts. So which the first part would be design and manufacture. And the materials alone are just $20 because it's a paper of Strip, and we're layering at the very end of the strip, we are layering and forced immune reaction. And lab research and design came out to be $2,000. The first prototype batch manufacturer is estimated to be $500, totaling the first part of design and manufacture to be $3,000 and $10, rough estimate. For part two of the production, which includes improvement and development, has been made clear that we want to keep the cost down in large quantities in order to make a good marginal return on profit. So, this process we got the price down to 45 cents per strip by batch. So that is with an estimated total of a $20,000 investment on the lab materials, so buying in bulk. For part three mass production, once the product is ready and the product can be produced at large quantities as needed, additional capital investments will be needed. This is estimated, the assumption that the product will be about 45 cents per strip as stated prior. So for the first year of sales, it will be very low because the first 10 months are dedicated to research and development, leaving us only 2 months for sales. It's estimated to be $3,960. This number comes from So we estimate the first month of sales to be a thousand strips conservatively for the first month and 3,000 total strips for the second month. Thus year one sales would lead to $3,960. Year two estimated sales are based off of a 20% growth per month. And if it continues to grow steadily, we will hope to reach 1.2 million sales in year three. So two options for exit strategy would be sale shares of the company's principals to an investor who holds equity or ownership of the position, or the sale of a merger of a company for debt-holding investors. For the company Strip, we decided to go with the second option. This is because the average hold period for investors is 3.5 years, So 3.5 years gives Strip enough time to develop the product fully and make it appealing to other companies. And on top of that, we would still have our patent values, adding a great asset. And if not, the product would hold more value independently because the patent on such a list would possibly be related to other indicator products such as GMO and soy, which I'll talk about later on the expansion of the company. Examples of target buyouts would be companies, pharmaceutical companies or home companies such as Teva, DuPont, Johnson & Johnson, Procter & Gamble. So for my validation and market research, I went around and I gave surveys to a random sample of people of all different ages and ethnicities. So it was made clear to me that they were most aware of the allergic reactions, which include numbness, burning sensation, tingling, facial pressure, chest pain, or breathing difficulty, headaches, nausea, rapid heartbeat, drowsiness, and weakness. They weren't so aware of the facts that it contributed to Alzheimer's, ALS, and all those other diseases. Responses to this product were that the problem with active ingredients is a very unknown problem. Only an extremely small population of people are aware of these problems. If this product were to succeed in the market, there needs to be a tremendous amount of public awareness. It's solely my opinion that the benefit of this product are overwhelming, good, and well-intended. I'm just not sure the market is there yet. Another response would be, I have enough tolerance with MSG and is not fully aware of adverse side effects. This testing kit will be very helpful use to the group of people who are sensitive to MSG and has a low tolerance, and especially allergic reactions. The market approach should focus on the targeted group. Education of broader groups would also help awareness of the MSG adverse effect and bring interest to the product. Another part of my market validation, I went to Magic Mix Juicery, which is an organic, vegan, gluten-free cafe shop, which is located right here on Fulton Street. So I made an appointment with the CEO and I told her, introduced my product, and asked her if she would be interested in such an available product, just possibly setting up on her counter. She said she was very interested. She is very health conscious and has a holistic view when it comes to foods and is always avoiding MSG, gluten, soy, all the above. So the feedback from her was to work on the logo, and in general, it was positive. She liked the idea of it, and she liked the price. I have a prototype of a prototype. So just to give you a general idea in size, it would be about this big, if not smaller. Take it out, you can put it in your pocket, very manageable. Just simple paper strips, and at the end it would have an immune response. You swipe it onto your food, and if it is indeed MSG positive, it'll turn green. I did talk to the small pharmaceutical company, and they reassured me that this is very viable. So you can pass that around. It's a homemade art project. For future projections, I was hoping to move into a snowball effect from this company. After the MSG testers struck off, we could keep on going into genetic modification, peanut strips, gluten strips, and soy protein isolates. Thank you.